Forecast an Earthquake, the text version, by Dutchsinse, Michael Yuri Janitch. Simply put, almost anyone can do earthquake forecasting down to a region of a few hundred miles, down to an approximate 7 to 10 day time period, and usually within one magnitude of what actually ends up striking. How to? Standing wave principles apply. See here for a video example, https://rumble.com/vbdn5d-conctic-s. Video above shows the whole process from deep earthquakes to the spread up, the halfway sorting and the spread out. Video shows concentric waves, into a singularity spike upwards, then a standing wave in a tank building power reflecting back into itself, then the middle points are sorted via vibration on a shake plate, then the wave travels as a soliton solitary wave of translation, then sorts to middle points again as it distributes out along the linear plate boundaries and across craton edges. Explanation. Between any two earthquakes, a middle point exists. Think of two earthquakes like two waves in a standing wave tank. Then a new earthquake, a new single wave of same size or combined larger, pops up in the middle point between the two previous waves. Like bookends, the two previous earthquakes define the area to watch for the new earthquake to strike in the near-term future. The middle point usually is struck with the combined total of both previous earthquakes. Example. Two 5.0s hit across Japan. One M5.0 on the south at Kyushu, one M5.0 on the north at Hokkaido. Then a few days later or less, a new M5.1 to M5.2 strikes the middle point at Tokyo. The standing wave usually spreads onwards along the plate boundaries and craton edges after striking in a particular area more than a few times. As the standing wave spreads, new sets of quakes occur at the halfway points previously mentioned. Just as a standing wave spreads in a tank, and then reflects into itself, earthquakes spread and strike the same way, but instead of being in a tank, the seismoelectrical wave which is spreading follows the plate boundaries and craton edges out and away from where the wave comes up. The seismoelectrical wave comes up from below the plates, coming up from the core itself as an ultra-low frequency or extremely low-frequency wave. When the seismoelectrical ULF/ELF wave comes up from the plasma core of the Earth, like lightning spreads up from the plate into the atmosphere. This seismoelectrical wave spreads up and out through the plate. The ULF/ELF seismoelectrical wave is usually accompanied by a deep earthquake recorded at the bottom of the plate receiving the wave, or even deeper below the plate receiving the wave in the semi-melted asthenosphere. The deep earthquake sizes, magnitudes, and locations are important. Much like we would pay attention to a storm dropping a large amount of precipitation on a river, we would watch for the river to flood, and the flow of the water to go downstream away from the origin point following a path of least resistance. Therefore, just like paying attention to a storm dropping a lot of rain, we need to pay attention to deep earthquakes as a sign of a large amount of low frequency energy being absorbed into the plate in that area. When a rainstorm drops large amounts of rain on a river, the river floods and the flow goes downstream/away from the origin point. The same can be said for this seismoelectrical wave. It follows a path of least resistance, however, instead of flowing downhill like water does, the seismoelectrical wave flows up out and away from the deep earthquake locations. Thus, this wave is not just electrical in nature, but also a traveling physical wave in some fashion I have yet to determine. It flows around plate boundaries and craton edges instead of directly across them. Path of least resistance is involved in some way yet to be determined. Regardless of how the process forms, the result is observable, somewhat equidistantly spaced earthquakes spreading out and away from the original deep earthquake locations. The spread of the earthquakes, the equidistant spacing of the quakes, is the sign of a standing wave, and the spacing between the quakes being thousands of miles between points defines the wave as a very low frequency wave or beyond into ULF/ELF. Summed up. Watch first for deep earthquakes, then watch next to the deep quakes for shallower larger earthquakes to spread up, out to a shallow depth and then away from the deep quake location, like a wave spreading out and away from a splash. Then, find the middle points between the current, past 48 hours of, earthquakes. This determines the new locations to watch in the next few days to be hit. Then you can track the spread and plot additional forecast points based upon the current earthquakes which already have struck.